Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. In this episode, I want to talk about the new ability to have user-defined messages with static assert. This is a C++ 26 feature, but compilers are already supporting it, which is, of course, why I am doing an episode about it. I want to do just a quick reminder that I am going to be at a lot of conferences this year, 2026, giving workshops. I'm going to be focusing on best practices, as I like to do, because I think it is very important that we do better as a community. So I'm just going to do a quick shout out to NDC Toronto, which is coming up this May. Today's episode is sponsored by JetBrains. CLion is a cross-platform JetBrains IDE for C and C++. It is ready for your projects out of the box and has everything you need to stay productive, focused, and in control. Deep language understanding with intelligent code assistance, comprehensive build system support, unit testing frameworks, advanced debugging, and embedded development. Use the code CPPWeeklyCLion to get 25% off when purchasing a new CLion subscription or renewing your existing one. So back to this new feature from C++ 26. We've been able to, since C++ 11, have static assert with a const expr that resolves to a Boolean and an unevaluated string. So this const expr right here means constant expression. That's what const expr has always meant. It is a portmanteau of constant and expression. And then some unevaluated string. This needs to just be a character string literal that is displayed. In C++ 17, they removed the requirement of having this unevaluated string, which often makes sense because often the thing that you're static asserting on is something that is kind of obvious. Like if it fails, the reason it failed is right there in the expression itself. C++ 26 added the ability to have this second parameter now be itself a constant expression. This constant expression must be something that has a size member that is convertible to a size t, and a data member that is convertible to a const character pointer, implicitly convertible to a const character pointer. I don't know if there's anything other than const character. Well, I guess you could have some sort of proxy type or something that has an implicit conversion to const character pointer. That could make sense. Anyhow, size and data is what this must have. So I'm going to show you what you want to do. I'm going to tell you why it's not going to work, and then I'm going to show you what you can do. So first of all, I can put the static assert false right here, and this is just going to simply fail to compile. Error, static assertion failed, false. Right, okay. So let's static assert on something a little bit more meaningful. I'm going to static assert that car is a pointer, which of course it's not. And I can see here, static assertion failed. This is the compile time error that I got. And this makes sense as a compile time error. And that's why the standard removed the necessity of having a description. The description was originally required. In C++ 11, you had to have this description. Again, it's a little redundant often. Of course, none of this makes sense in just a regular context here. So let's go ahead and put this thing in a template. I just want to point out that I'd probably actually want to use a constraint here, a requires clause, but for the sake of this example, I'm not going to. All right, no matching function for call to do things. Oh, because I didn't pass it as a template parameter, which is what I want to do. Static assertion failed. Now up here, I do get this with auto value equals 4 thing. And I see do things of 4, but then I see static assertion failed. Okay, the comparison reduces to 4 is greater than 5. This is giving me a lot more information than I might have thought. What you want to do to be able to actually get as meaningful of a message as possible is probably something like standard format, like this. I will go ahead and include the format header. Then I will find out that standard format is not yet const expr capable. I think this was accepted for 26, but as far as I can tell, it has not been merged into the standard yet. You may or may not know this, but lib format has actually been const expr capable for some time now. It is const expert capable with its format 2 capability, and it takes a little bit more work to actually get it working than we would hope for. So I'm going to go ahead and paste this in here. Now, I borrowed this from Matoush Push, and you can actually check out links in the description for this video where I've got a link to my GitHub repository, and it also then has a link to the lib format discussion on this particular topic, and you can see where I got this particular implementation from. This is using standard format, and I don't want to use standard format. I now want to use Lefticus format. And this is just doing a format 2. Now, format 2 is const expr in libformat, but format is not. It returns a string, but string is const expr capable, so this is all allowed. Now, normally, you're not allowed to return a string from a const eval function because anything that's been allocated at compile time has to be freed at compile time, and this kind of breaks those rules. I think this works because the program never actually finishes compiling in the case where it fails. So it kind of short circuits on the first thing. I'm pretty sure that's what's happening here. It's actually a little surprising. All right, so I'm gonna do Lefticus format, and then I need to use this macro that forces compilation of the format string itself at compile time. For this to work, you need to make sure that you have a very recent version of libformat. Now I see the static assertion failed, and I get my error message, expected 5, got 4. So yes, it is possible currently with jumping through a few hoops, but hopefully by the time we actually get C++ 26, there will be a little bit cleaner way to do this. On the other hand, this is not a very complicated function to have to put in your library if you want to do this. Anyhow, I hope you thought this was interesting. Thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. I'll catch you next week.